Welcome. In this video, I'm going to calculate exponential smoothing forecasts for this time series data in Excel and use Solver to determine the best smoothing constant or alpha value. I'm going to calculate absolute errors, squared errors, and absolute percent errors. For now, I've chosen a random value for alpha, which is 0.4 here. In exponential smoothing, if you're not given a forecast for the first period, then the forecast is the actual value for the first period. Consequently, it will be the forecast for the second period as well. So we start by setting the forecast in the second period to the actual value in the first period. Our first calculation is therefore in the third period. The formula is alpha times actual in the last period plus 1 minus alpha times forecast in the last period. We type equals alpha and press F4 to make it absolute. In essence, those dollar signs ensure that the alpha cell is locked down when we copy the formula here to other cells. So, alpha times actual in the second period plus 1 minus alpha, F4 to lock it down, times the forecast in the second period. Then grab the handle and drag it down till period 7. For the absolute errors, we type equals ABS and then actual minus forecast value. You can then double click on the handle to copy the formula all the way down. For the squared error, square the absolute error and double-click the handle to copy it down. For absolute percent error, divide the absolute error by the actual value and multiply by 100. Then double-click to copy it down. To find MAD, we use equals average to find the mean of the absolute errors. Then drag to copy the formula for MSE and MAPE. Next, we determine the best alpha using Excel Solver. Note that the best alpha that will minimize MAD may differ from the one that will minimize MSE. Click the Data tab, then Solver. If you don't see Solver there, please see description on how to install it. Now, suppose we want the best alpha that minimizes MAD. For set objective, we click on the MAD value. Click mean for minimization. The variable value we want to change is alpha. So we click the alpha value for the changing variable cells. Now, alpha needs to be between 0 and 1. This checked box here says make unconstrained variable non-negative. That is, we'll leave this box checked if we want alpha to be greater than or equal to 0. To ensure alpha is less than or equal to 1, we click Add here to add the constraint. For cell reference, we select the alpha value. Make sure the less than or equal sign is selected, then input 1 on the right here. Click OK. Leave this method here as nonlinear and click Solve. You can see here that the optimal alpha value is 0.3084. That is, to obtain the smallest MAD possible, we should set alpha to about 0.3084. Now let's determine the best alpha that will minimize MSE. We now set the objective to the MSE value. The other settings from before are still valid. Click Solve. And we can see here that the best alpha that minimizes MSE is 0.3144. Doing the same for MAPE, we obtain 0.3084, just like with MAD. And that's how to use Solver to find the best alpha for exponential smoothing.